subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. From today, we are going to start MCET crash course. Okay, so coming to this crash course, it will be for 30 days, 30, okay? So this is completely 30 days crash course. In this crash course, we are going to discuss the most important questions and the most important topics from MPC as well as BIPC. That is, we will be covering mathematics, physics, chemistry, botany and zoology, okay? So coming to the technique or tip which I would like to give you is, if there's a sincere request from my side is, first please learn all the formulae from mathematics, physics as well as chemistry. Okay, so if you know the formulae, then it will be very, very easy for you people to understand what I am explaining, because as it is a crash course, formula you should already learn. I'll be teaching the problems directly with the help of the formula. Okay, so for the students who are non-English, like the students who can't understand English much, for them in between I'll be teaching in Telugu also. So students, ee roju nunchi manaki manamu MCET 30 days crash course anedi nechukuntunnam. So indulo manamu MCET, MPC మరియు బైపీసీ రెండు కూడా కవర్ చేస్తాము. అంటే మ్యాథ్స్, ఫిజిక్స్, కెమిస్ట్రీ, బాటనీ, జువాలజీ ఇవన్నీ కూడా మనము కవర్ చేస్తాము. ఈ క్రాష్ కోర్స్ ఏంటంటే 30 డేస్ ఉంటుంది. అండ్ ఈ 30 రోజుల క్రాష్ కోర్స్ తర్వాత మీకు చాలా కాన్ఫిడెన్స్ వస్తుంది. అండ్ 120 కన్నా ఎక్కువ మార్క్స్ స్కోర్ చేసే స్కోప్ ఉంటుంది, లైక్ మీరు కనుక నా క్లాస్ బాగా విని అన్నీ ఫాలో అవుతాయి. అండ్ ఈ క్లాస్ అటెండ్ అయ్యే ముందు, లైక్ ఈ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ అర్థం అవ్వాలంటే ఫస్ట్ మీకు కాన్సెప్ట్ అనేది కొంచెం ఆల్రెడీ ఐడియా ఉండాలి. అంతేకాకుండా మ్యాథ్స్, ఫిజిక్స్, కెమిస్ట్రీ వీటిలో ఫార్ములా ఏవైతే ఉంటాయో అవి మీరు ఆల్రెడీ నేర్చుకుని ఉండాలి, ఓకేనా? సో ఆ ఫార్ములా తెలిస్తేనే మనకి ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ అనేది అర్థమవుతుంది. మాకు ఫార్ములా రాదు మేడం అనే వాళ్ళకి ఏంటంటే, ఏం చేయాలంటే బెస్ట్ వే టు స్టడీ అంటే మన ఛానల్ దగ్గర ఆల్రెడీ ఫిజిక్స్, కెమిస్ట్రీ, మ్యాథ్స్ ఈ అన్ని ఫార్ములా ఒక స్టడీ మెటీరియల్ లాగా ప్రిపేర్ చేసి రెడీగా ఉంచాము స్టూడెంట్స్కి హెల్ప్ అవ్వాలి అనే ఉద్దేశంతో. సో మీరేం చేయాలంటే లింక్ అదే డిస్క్రిప్షన్లో ఒక మెయిల్ అడ్రస్ ఉంటుంది, ఆ మెయిల్ అడ్రస్కి కనుక మీరు మెయిల్ చేస్తే ఆ స్టడీ మెటీరియల్ అనేది నేను మీకు ప్రొవైడ్ చేస్తాను. లేకపోతే డిస్క్రిప్షన్లో ఒక ఫోన్ నెంబర్ ఉంటుంది, అట్లీస్ట్ ఆ ఫోన్ నెంబర్కైనా కూడా మీకు మీరు వాట్సాప్ అనేది చేయొచ్చు. అండ్ మన సబ్స్క్రైబర్స్కి 10% ఆఫ్, 10% డిస్కౌంట్ అనేది వస్తుంది. ఇది ఓన్లీ మన సబ్స్క్రైబర్స్కి మాత్రమే. అందుకని వెంటనే మన ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకుని పక్కన ఉన్న బెల్ ఐకన్ కొట్టండి. సో నౌ కమింగ్ టు ద స్టూడెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ నాన్ తెలుగు, లైక్ ద ఇంగ్లీష్ స్టూడెంట్స్, యాజ్ ఐ టోల్డ్ యూ షుడ్ ఆల్రెడీ హ్యావ్ లెర్న్డ్ ఆల్ ద ఫార్ములే. ఇఫ్ యూ ఫీల్ ఇఫ్ యూ ఆర్ లైక్ యూఆర్ నాట్ రియలీ గుడ్ విత్ ద ఫార్ములే, దెన్ యూ కెన్ purchase a study material which contains only formula. If you want to purchase that study material, you can mail me. My mail address is in the description box below, or you can also WhatsApp to the number which is in the description box. Okay, so our subscribers will be getting 10% discount on the study material only of to our subscribers. So if you wanted to get 10% offered, what you need to do is you just need to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get the 10% off. Okay, so now let's begin this video without any delay. As I have already told you, first let's start with the mathematics, algebra, functions. Okay, so coming to this particular problem, it is one of the most important problem, especially in this crash course I will be only dealing with most important questions. Okay, so this is the first question. Coming to the question, if f of x is equal to cos of log x, then f of x and f of y is minus 1/2 of f of x by y plus f of xy is equal to how much. So now, did you understand the question? Read the question very, very carefully. This is very important question. So now let's start solving with this problem. First, they gave. Okay, let's solve this problem. First, take the first statement. If f of x is equal to cos of log x, this is already given in the question. This is already given in the question. Now they are asking you have to find the value of this. Okay, so in question they already gave the value of f of x. F of x is equal to cos of log x. So with the help of this we can derive the equation for f of y. So f of y is equal to nothing, students. It's very, very easy. In place of x we are putting y, that's it. Okay, is equal to cos of log, in place of x we are putting y. Simple. Okay, this is statement one, this is statement two. Clear till here? Okay, so nothing. First they gave an equation, we took that equation. With the help of that equation, like they gave the value of f of x, and with the help of this f of x we have found the value of f of y by just substituting y in place of x. Okay, clear till here? Now let's see, what are they asking us to find. Okay, so they are asking us to find the value of this f of x, f of y minus 1 by 2 of f of x by y plus f of xy is equal to how much? So we have to find the value of this. Okay, the equation which they asked us to solve. Here we are doing nothing, we are just substituting the values. Okay, we know the value of f of x, we have found, already it's given as a question. So f of x value is, or you will get the value from the statement one, cos of log x. Okay, so f of y value can be derived from the equation two, which is f of y is equal to cos of log y minus 1 by 2, we are writing as it is, 1 by 2 of, clear till here students? Clear till here, right? So f of x by y. F of x by y. Okay, so we don't know the value of f of x by y. Let's see how we have to find this value. Okay, let's see how to find f of x by y value. F of x by y is equal to nothing, take f of x. See, f of x by y, f of x. So here instead of x put x by y. Simple. F of x by y is equal to cos of log, instead of x we are putting x by y. Got it? Easy, right? So in the same way we will find the value of f of xy. F of xy is nothing but cos of log, instead of x by y we are writing xy. Simple, right? Now we are just substituting the values of f of x by y. Okay, let it be statement 3 and let it be statement 4. Okay, so now we are just substituting the values of f of x by y and f of xy. Okay, so f of x by y, we already found it. F of x by y value is cos of cos of log x by y, okay, plus f of xy value is cos of log x y. Okay, clear till here? Clear till here, right? Okay, so we are clear till here. If anybody wants to note it down, just go back a little bit and you can note it all this down. Okay, or you can also take the screenshot just by going a few minutes back of this video. Okay. Okay, clear till here. So now this is our latest equation, which is cos of log x plus, we are writing same as it is equation here, okay, plus cos of log y minus 1 by 2 of cos of log x by y plus cos of log xy. This is the equation which we have derived. Okay? Till here, clear, right? Till here, we are very clear. Now, what we need to do is, divided by, and if you solve divided by a divided by b, it can also be written as like this. Or coming to into a into b can also be written as like this. So all this basic formula you should know, okay? So using this particular formulae, we are getting the answer directly, which is, we are writing this as it is, cos of log x plus log cos of log y is equal to, sorry, minus, okay, this is in the form of a plus b. Am I correct or not? A plus b. So the students who knows the formula can happily directly go. Okay, this is in the form of a plus b, which can be written as minus 1 by 2 into 2. That's why I'm saying students, our formula is very, very important. The students who know the formula can directly solve like this. Like you will be getting cos of log x by y log x log x into cos of log y. Okay, got it? Nothing. It is in the form of a plus b, so which came in turn of a into b. I already told you formula is very important. There's a direct correlation between multiplication and division, multiplication and addition. And there's a direct correlation between division and subtraction. Okay, so till here, clear, right? Last step is you can cancel 2 with 2, log x minus cos log x minus cos log x, cos log y minus cos log y, which gives 0. So the ultimate solution, the value of the given question which they asked us to derive is 0. Okay, finally, we got the finally we got the solution as 0. Okay. Coming to the next question, given the function, what function they gave? f of x is equal to a power x plus a power minus x divided by 2, where a is greater than 2. They gave a condition, a should be greater than 2. Okay, this is the condition which they gave. Then what are they asking us to find f of x plus y plus f of x minus y. This is the value which they asked us to find. Easy, right? This is also one of the most important question. First of all, what are they asking us to find? They are asking us to find f of x plus y plus f of x minus y is equal to how much. But here in the question, we have to remember they gave a condition clearly, which is a must be greater than 2. Okay, so a can be 3, a value can be 4, a value can be 10 or 20, 30, how much ever it wants, but it must be greater than 2. Okay, so here we know the value of f of x. They have already given the value of f of x. It can be written as f of x plus y. Okay, so first we have to derive the values of f of x and f of x plus y and f of x minus y. So coming to f of x plus y, we are taking the same, but in place of x, we are putting x plus y, okay? So, a power x plus y plus a power minus x plus y divided by 2. This is the equation which is derived with the help of the given equation. Okay, now we have to derive the equation of this. F of x minus y is equal to a power x minus y plus a power minus x minus y divided by 2. We got the same two, we got two equations. Now we are just substituting these values. This is statement 1, this is statement 2. We are substituting both the statements in this given question. Easy? Okay. So after substitution, what will we get? See, as you can observe, both equations have divided by 2 and divided by 2. So what I can write, I can just take the 1 by 2 as out, like the both has divided by 2. So I am taking 1 by 2 as a common value, and now I am writing remaining as it is. Okay. A power x plus y plus a power minus x minus of x plus y, which is minus x minus y plus f of x by y means this value like by 2 we have already taken out as common. Now remaining values we have to write, which is a power, which is a power x minus y plus a power minus of x minus y, right? So minus into plus minus minus x minus into minus plus, so plus y. This is the equation which we derived by just substituting. Okay, so now if you observe more cleverly, okay, so I'm rubbing this question students because we got the final statement and we can continue with the same. Okay, this is the final statement which we got. So if you can observe, we can still remove the common values from this statement. Okay, so what common values? We can remove the common value of x. Here it is common, so half into a power x. When we take common, we will be getting a power y. Okay, a power y plus a power minus y. Got it? A power y, just nothing. I'm just taking a power x as common. Okay, now put plus as it is. And now if you observe, I can take a power minus x as common. Okay, a power minus x as common. So a power minus x is equal into a power y as it is plus a power minus x when I took it common. So here it will come a power minus y. Got it? Easy, right? Till here clear, right? Now what we are doing is we are clubbing both the common values under one bracket and clubbing these both under another bracket. See, both are same. That's why we are clubbing these two. 1 by 2 into a power x and clubbing both these plus a power minus x under one bracket. As it is, we have to write. Okay. Now, what is remaining? Another value of a brace is remaining. This is left out. See, I wrote a power x plus a power minus x. Now left over is this. I'm writing as it is. Plus a power minus y. Clear till here? So clear till here, right? Do you remember this equation which they gave in question? They gave f of y value, which is a power x plus a power minus y divided by 2. If you see this equation, we have the same values. We have a power x plus a power minus x divided by 2 and a power y plus a power minus y divided by 2, which can be written as 2 of f. This is f of x value and this is y, f of y value. Simple, very, very easy, right? Nothing. We are just substituting by using a little logic. Okay, very, very easy questions these are. So now let's see next question. So coming to the next question. Let F be R to R. Okay. Be defined by F of X. Be defined by F of X, where f of x is equal to they gave the value of f of x, which is f of x value, which is 2x plus x. Got it? Now they are asking us to find what is the value of, what is the value of what is the value of f of 2x plus f of minus x, f of 2x plus f of minus x minus f of x. So this is the value which we need to find it out. Students, read the question once again. Read this question very carefully, because this is very, very important question. As I told, mainly we are concentrating on most important questions only in this crash course. Okay, so we know the value of f of x. Now we have to find these values individually. Let's solve. F of x is equal to 2x plus x. This is already given in the question. Now we have to find out f of 2x. F of 2x is nothing but, in place of x we are putting 2x. So 2 into 2x plus 2x, which can be written as 4x plus 2x. Got it? Simple, right? 4x plus 2x. Now this is equation 2 or statement 2, whatever you call it as. Okay. Now we are finding the value of f of minus x. F of minus x is very, very easy. Just put minus in place of x. Minus x, okay, 2 of minus x plus minus x. This is the statement 3. Now nothing, we are just substituting. Why I didn't find f of x value is because they have already given directly in the question. Okay, so now what we are doing is we are just substituting the values which we found. F of 2x value which we found is 4x plus 2 of x. Clear till here? Next. See, inside this there will be no negatives. Okay, so directly we can write it as plus minus 2x. This negative value I have brought it to second place and brought this positive value to, I just swapped it. Okay, nothing to get confused. And now we have to write the value of, see, f of 2x value I have written, f of minus x value we have written. Now the remaining value, very easy, it is just put minus in front of this, you will be getting this value. Okay, so it's very easy. Minus 2x minus x. Okay, clear till here? Now once you solve all these statements, like 4x minus 2x minus 2x, so 4x minus 4x, okay, and plus x minus x, what is left? Plus 2x, which can also be written as 2x. So this is the final solution, and this is the value of f of minus 2x plus f of minus x minus f of x. This is also one of the most important question which you need to learn. Okay, done with this question, right? So now let's see what is the next question. Okay, so coming to the next question, if f of x is equal to, if f of x is equal to log of 1 plus x by 1 plus x by 1 minus x, then find. Now, what are they asking us to find? F of x, sorry, f of, now they are asking us to find f of 2x by 1 plus x square. They are asking us to find this value. First, let's take this equation f of x is equal to the given equation, which is given already in the question. It can be also written as log, like if the students who know the formula can easily understand this question, okay, it can also be written as, I have already told you, x plus x square plus 1. Now, what we are doing is we are substituting. Now, just forget about this value. Remember only this value, f of x is equal to log of x plus root of x square plus 1. Now, what we are doing is we are substituting the same in this value, f of 2x. Like they have asked to find the value of f of 2x divided by 1 plus x square in the question, right? So we are doing the same here. We are just substituting. So f of, so in place of x, we are writing this value. So log of, in place of x, 2x divided by 1 plus x square plus under root, instead of x square, you have to write 2x divided by 1 plus x square whole square plus 1. Okay. So after solving, we got this. So this particular thing can also be written as, like after solving this equation, it can also be written as log of 1 plus x divided by 1 minus x whole square. Easy. Just we are solving it, that's it, nothing else. And this square I'm bringing here, which can be written as 2 log 1 plus x divided by 1 minus x. Clear till here? Which is, see, what is this? This is the value of f of x, right? So it can be written as 2 f of x, because f of x value is log of 1 plus x by 1 divided by 1 minus x. So I have already, like, finally written it as 2 is equal to 2 of, so the value, the final value is 2 f of x. So now let's solve next question. Guys, we are really working hard for you people. So please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and also please hit the bell icon. Also do share and like this video. Please like, so that we'll get motivation and do more and more useful videos. And I'm repeating one thing, like the students who don't know the formulae and want to learn all the formulae in just 1 or 2 days, please purchase the study material from Best Way to Study, so that you can solve any problem of mathematics, because coming to max, formula is very important. So now coming to next question, if f of x is equal to, if f of x is equal to 1 divided by x plus 2 and 2x minus 4, x plus 2 and under root of 2x minus 4 plus x minus 2 under root of 2x 2x minus 4. So 2x minus 4, but here they gave a condition that x must be greater than 2. This is the condition to be remembered. And now what are they saying? They are asking us to find the value of f of 11. They are asking us to find the value of f of 11. Okay, simple, right? This is most important and easiest problem I can say. Okay, so f of x value we already know. We have to find f of 11 value. So nothing in place of x, we have to substitute 11. F of 11 is equal to 1, is equal to 1 by under root 11 plus 2 under root 2 of 11 minus 4 plus 1 by under root 11 minus 2 under root 2 of 11 minus 4. Easy, right? Divided by 11 plus 2 under root 22, 2 into 11, 22 minus 4 plus 1 by under root 11 minus 2 of 2 into 11, 22 minus 4. Keep solving. Under root 11 plus 2 or 22 minus 4 is 18 plus 1 by 11 minus 2 under root of 22 minus 4 is 18. Clear till here? Now, if you keep solving like this, if you keep solving slowly like this, you will be getting 6 by 7. Okay, nothing very, very easy. Just as I simplified, you have to follow the same formula, like the same method, and simplify it. Finally, you will be getting 6 by 7. Coming to the next question, what is the inverse of the function 10 power x minus 10 power minus x divided by 10 power x plus 10 power minus x? Inverse of function. They are asking us to find the inverse of the function. Okay, very, very easy and basic problem. Okay, so now what we need to do is now let us just assume y is equal to, let's assume, okay, let y is equal to 10 power x minus 10 power minus x divided by 10 power x plus 10 power minus x. Let us just assume let y is the given equation. Okay. So now what we need to do is, with the help of this, we have to derive x value. Okay. We assume that the given equation is y, and from that equation we are deriving x. So x is equal to, very easy, there is a formula. The students who know the formula, do let me know in the comment section below. Okay, so the formula for this is like, using the formula, if you solve, you will be getting 1 by 2 log 10 log base 10 of 1 plus y divided by 1 minus y. It is just using the formula, you can get this. Okay, nothing hidden. It's just a simple formula. You have to use that formula and do this. Okay, so y is equal to f of x. we got y is equal to f of x. We are just assuming, let y is equal to, this is nothing but f of x, right? Because see, we got the f value, we got x, and this is in the form of f of x. We are just assuming y is equal to f of x. So it can also be written as x is equal to f inverse y. You understood it, right? F inverse y. Easy. Nothing. This is the value of y. This is the value of x, which is in the form of f of x. Okay, so we got y is equal to f of x, and it can be also written as x is equal to f inverse y. I'll give you a simple logic. One by y can also be written as, right? In the same way, we are using this formula. Okay. Of course, a by b can also be written as a minus b. 2a by b can also be written as 2a by b is equal to 3. What we can do, a by b is equal to, send this side, so into becomes divided by, so all these logics using this, these are nothing but formulae. Okay, so x is equal to f inverse y. So now we know the y value already, so we are just substituting it. X is equal to f inverse of y value is this, we already know it, right? Just substitute. Alright, clear till here? So after solving this, we will be getting, so okay, we got x value, but here we are asked to find the inverse of the value, that is inverse of x. So f inverse of x, this is what we were asked to find in the question, right? So f inverse of x is equal to, inverse is nothing but 1 by 2. 1 by 2 log 10, same like this only. Log 10 of, this is f of y, right? This is f inverse y value. In the same way, see, here we have y, here we have x. So instead of y, put x and write the same thing. 1 plus y. So here we have to write x divided by 1 minus y. So here we have to write x, 1 minus x. So this is how we have to solve this problem. Okay.